the air heavy with expectation. The earth holds its breath, all creation still cries out. Somewhere in the distance, the voice, his voice, still calls through the mist. It is finished. Into your hands I commit my spirit. In pieces and fragments, hints and images, the story comes to us. A vineyard garden, grapes ready for the harvest. A stone that is rolled away while guards remain asleep at its side. A pile of clothes folded into the empty tomb. Peter and John, off in the distance, are running with disbelief. Mary stays behind, weeping in the garden. Through her tears, we see angels seated in victory on top of the stone. Do not be afraid, they tell us. He is not here. We pause. Why do you look for the living among the dead? He is not here. And like a voice from heaven, Mary hears that voice, the voice she is longing for. The gardener speaks her name, Mary. Jesus' face appears and speaks. What the angel said was true and is true today. Jesus is alive. Jesus still journeys with the poor, the marginalized, the disenfranchised. His heart beats in victory. Easter is announced by every breath he takes. Easter means that love has won. Death is finished. Evil is conquered. The world is called to transform. God is good. Love's redeeming work is done. The vigil of waiting is over. It is finished. It is finished. It is finished. He is not dead. He is alive. And together we sing.
Christ the Lord is risen today, hallelujah. All creation joined to say, hallelujah. Raise your joys and triumphs high, hallelujah. Sing, O heavens and earth.
may be seated. Good morning and happy Easter. Welcome to worship this morning here at Port Elgin United Church. For those of you that I may not know, I am Reverend Jeffrey Dale, and I am pleased to be welcoming you to worship this morning. If you are a guest, please make yourself known to us. You may speak to myself after the service or join others in coffee hour in the gymnasium just down the hallway. As we prepare our hearts and minds for worship this morning, we begin with the sharing of announcements that anyone might have.
Good morning. My name is June Van Bastelaar, and I'm just going to give you a reminder that next Sunday, April 7th, we will be having a short congregational meeting right after the service. The search team is going to present to you the person that they have found to be our new minister. So please make sure that you're here next Sunday and that you do stay for the meeting after the service. Also, just a very quick reminder, there is a big celebration next Saturday, which will be the 6th, for Vi Cottrell, and you are invited and to the auction and to the event, and also to, if you wish to make a monetary donation to help Vi out with the expenses. She's now, as you know, probably already know, at Hampton Court in Southampton and doing very, very well.
Thank you, Jim. Thank you to our AV team, Susan and George. Thank you to Jenny for your work music leadership, to Joan and Zoe down in Discovery Cove, to all of you present here with us this morning, to those present online and on television for joining us for worship. And as we gather in community, we do so in taking time to recognize, reflect, and engage with the people of this land. We acknowledge that we worship on the traditional lands and treaty territory of the Saugeen Ojibwe Nation, which consists of the Chippewas of Saugeen and the Chippewas of Nawash unceded First Nations. This land, since time immemorial, has been home to the people of the Saugeen Ojibwe Nation. We are grateful for the opportunity to live and work alongside the indigenous people of this land. As we commit ourselves to being better stewards in relationship with creation, we also commit ourselves to writing relationships with indigenous people. Today, we hear the words of the moderator, the former moderator, the very Reverend Dr. Stan Mackay. The resurrection happened. We are given new life. In our journey together, there are painful moments, but there is always the hope of Christ. We have journeyed from a walk within darkness and pain to a transformed, liberated people. A people who not only walked in the light, but a people who share that light where darkness still prevails in many places. This is not to say that the journey is at an end. Instead, it is to say that it is a new beginning. There is a new beginning in every person who turns again to Christ, in every community where healing may begin because of the courage of those who shared their understanding of Christ's message. A new beginning as the world begins to embrace the truths the elders have taught about the integrity of creation. The vision of the future is rooted in this wisdom. It is not only a truth to assist us individually and in the local communities, but it is a vision which the world as a global village must embrace in order to build a new world. And as a community of faith within the larger body of the United Church of Canada, we are dedicated to deepening our understanding of our denomination's past, present, and future relationships with Indigenous peoples across Turtle Island and all our relations. Join with me now in our call to worship. We sing of Jesus, a Jew born to a woman in poverty in a time of social upheaval and political oppression. He knew human joy and sorrow. So filled with the Holy Spirit was he that in him people experienced the presence of God among them. We sing praises to God incarnate. Jesus announced the coming of God's reign, a commonwealth not of dominion, but of peace, justice, and reconciliation. He healed the sick and fed the hungry. He forgave sins and freed those held captive. By all manners of demonic powers, he crossed barriers of race, class, culture, and gender. He preached and practiced unconditional love, love of God, love of neighbor, love of friend, love of enemy. And he commanded all his followers to love one another as he loved them, because his witness to love was so threatening. Those who exercising power sought to silence Jesus. He suffered abomination, named their trail, state-sanctioned torture, and execution. He was crucified. But death was not the last word. God raised Jesus from death, turning sorrow into joy, despair into hope. We sing of Jesus raised from the dead. Let's pray. God, our Creator, source of compassion and reconciliation, by the saving power of the death and resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ, you decided to save humanity from the vicious cycle of hatred, violence, and death. Pour your power upon all your children, those living in spaces of conflict and isolation, those living in spaces of stigma and hate, those living with their backs against the wall. Let swords of the powerful be turned into plowshares, fear to trust, despair to hope, oppression to freedom, starvation to poverty, occupation to liberation, and peace and justice to be experienced by all. Make us agents of your peace, O God, so that we may join people of goodwill who raise before Jerusalem's gates their insistent prayer that peace within your walls, peace be within you. Amen. And with Easter morning and with the passing of the peace, we are coming into a season where light is returning. The light of community calls us into this place. And so with that, we greet one another.
Good morning. The first scripture reading this morning is from Psalm 118, verses 1 to 4, 14, and 19 to 24. Give thanks to the Eternal because God is always good. God never ceases to be loving and kind. Let the people of the Holy Lands proclaim, God never ceases to be loving and kind. Let the priests of Aaron's line proclaim, God never ceases to be loving and kind. Let the people who fear the Eternal proclaim, God never ceases to be loving and kind. God is my strength and also the reason I sing. God has been there to save me in every situation. Open wide to me the gates of justice so that I may walk through them and offer praise and worship to the Eternal. This is the gate of the Eternal. The righteous children of God will go through it. I will praise you because you answered me when I was in trouble. You have become my salvation. The stone that the builders rejected has become the very stone that holds together the entire foundation. This is the work of the Eternal, and it is marvelous in our eyes. This is the day the Eternal God has made. Let us celebrate and be happy today. This is the word of the Lord.
This is the day that God has made. Rejoice, rejoice, and be exceeding glad. This is the day that God has made. Rejoice, rejoice.
One thing that still hasn't happened up front here, can anybody name it? Well, that was pretty good. How many people are sitting here going, when's that going to be lit? Well, now's the time. What does the Christ candle mean to us, though? This candle that has been extinguished since Thursday, what does it mean to us as a community? That God is present? Can we go a bit further? Was God present for that whole time? Well, that's a good one. Anybody else? Making you think this morning. It's not all chocolate and bunnies, that's for sure. Yeah. God's light shines. Yes. God's presence, God's light shines. Those are great. Do you want to say that? God has risen. Christ has risen. So when we say Christ has risen, does anybody know how you respond? Hallelujah. Hallelujah is good, or he is risen indeed. So let's try that. Christ has risen.
He is risen indeed.
Well, that's like he's half risen, so let's try it again. Okay? Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed.
I think he has now. Wonderful. Well, as we prepare to light our Christ candle, is there anyone that wants to come up and do that for us? You? No. We can wait. We thought the tomb was open, but maybe we'll just wait for somebody to open the tomb. Anyone? Oh, perfect. Dennis, way in the back, hiding in the back pews. Thank you, Dennis. And with the light of Christ returning into our community, we say together, Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
When I am down and oh my soul so weary, when troubles come and my heart burdened be, then I am still and wait here in the silence until you come.
And now we join together in the words of a new creed. We are not alone. We live in God's world. We believe in God, who has created and is creating, who has come in Jesus, the Word made flesh, to reconcile and make new, who works in us and others by the Spirit. We trust in God. We are called to be the church, to celebrate God's presence, to live with respect in creation, to love and serve others, to seek justice and resist evil, to proclaim Jesus crucified and risen, our judge and our hope, in life, in death, in life beyond death. God is with us. We are not alone. Thanks be to God. Our gospel message today comes to us from the Gospel of Mark, chapter 16, verses 1 through 8. When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James, and Salome brought spices so that they might go and anoint him. And very early on, the first day of the week, when the sun had risen, they went to the tomb. They had been saying to one another, "Who will roll away the stone for us to enter into the tomb?" When they looked up, they saw that the stone, which was very large, had already been rolled back. As they entered the tomb, they saw a young man dressed in a white robe, sitting on the right side, and they were alarmed. But he said to them, "Do not be alarmed. You are looking for Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified. He has been raised. He is not here. Look, there is the place that they laid him. But go, tell his disciples and Peter that he is going ahead of you to Galilee. There you will see him just as you have been told." So they went out and fled from the tomb, for terror and amazement had seized them. And they said nothing to anyone along the journey, for they were afraid. Here ends the reading. Let's pray. God, who is the liberated and resurrected Christ, be present in the meditations of our heart, in the conversation that is shared, and in the presence of community that is felt in the warmth of your light, warmth of your presence, warmth of your light returning to this earth, warmth of the resurrection of Christ, our Redeemer, our Sustainer, our Guide, and our Advocate. Amen. The picture you will see up on the slideshow was created in the 1970s by a man named Willis Wheatley. Willis Wheatley worked for the United Church of Canada's head office as an illustrator and was asked by the United Church to create a series of images of Jesus. Many different images depicting Jesus along the way, images that may be very familiar to some, of Jesus in sorrow, Jesus in contemplation, and then this image. This image, which he titled Christ the Liberator. Over the years, this image, before copyright became a thing, was shared throughout the world and has become known throughout the world as the Laughing Jesus. For some, it has been seen as sacrilegious. For others, it has been seen as a great joy. Some ministers seem to use it on Sundays when they want to infuse humor into their service. During the pandemic, I found myself kind of bored at home, like most of us. And someone on Facebook Marketplace was selling one of the original prints of this image. So I got my dog in the car and we drove down to Niagara Falls to meet the person at the border. I felt a little weird buying a picture of Jesus across the border, but anyway, it was legal, so it's fine. But for me, it's not a Christ who is laughing. It is not just a Christ who is sort of present in the moment. It is the reminder that on this day in our church, we are called into Christ's purpose of liberation in this world. That is the image of what liberation looks like when all who live in this world are fed, are sheltered, are given clean drinking water, have their basic and beyond basic needs met. That is the Christ that calls us this morning into the presence of the empty tomb. The Christ who waits for this image to be reality in our world. It is not finished, as was said on Good Friday. In fact, what was finished, or should have been finished, is the old ways of doing things. It is now on Easter Sunday that we are called into a transformative place and space of change, of purpose, of ministry in this world. We are called to join with Christ in the resurrection to be a liberating people in this world. It can be tough. It can be hard. It can be difficult to try to figure out exactly how we are called into that liberation. For some of us, it may be more comfortable to be stuck in the old ways. For some of us, it may be comfortable to ignore the things we see around us. For some of us, it may be comfortable to just simply be. But that's the thing. The resurrection was not comfortable. Mark writes that the women were amazed and terrified. If liberation is not both amazing and terrifying, then I don't know what it is. For you see, we are called into a new world order with Christ, through Christ, and by Christ on this day. We are called to shed the cloaks of stigma. We are called to shed the dressings of hate. We are called into the presence of God's light. Willis Wheatley's image changed the way in which the church could talk about Jesus. He wasn't so serious anymore, or so people thought. He wasn't so depicted as what I call the white Jesus. Some people might have seen that picture before. This Jesus defies race. He wasn't so wrapped up in mere personal salvation. The liberation of Christ in resurrection is our liberation if we choose to take it. If we choose to open our church doors to the resurrection of the world. If we choose to open ourselves to the reality that we, as our creed says, are not alone in this world. We are God's agents of hope, of respect, of service. But we must take the resurrection serious. It's not, as I made a joke before, merely a day for family meals, for chocolate, for bunnies. All those things are great, and I won't deny that. But it is a day in which we as Christians must recognize that the world has changed. If we choose to be involved in the changing of that world. If we choose to be the ones who take everything that Christ taught while on earth, everything Christ was while on earth, everything Christ wanted while he was on earth, into our hearts, into our souls, into our minds, into our very beings, and live it out. We must clothe the naked. We must feed the hungry. We must shelter the unsheltered. We must try to find a way to lay it all on the line, or else what's the point of a resurrected God? It's not easy. I have to constantly check myself to make sure that I am prepared to follow that resurrected God. We all need to do that so that we can one day join Christ in this image. One day we can too be liberated by the resurrection. One day we too can sing, as that old Negro spiritual taught us, that we are free at last. Thank God Almighty, we are free at last. Amen. We sing together, "I Danced in the Morning," from Voices United, number 352.
I danced in the morning when the world was begun, and I danced in the moon and the stars and the sun, and I came from thank you.
Our offering will now be received. Let's pray. God, we are grateful for the many gifts that are brought into your community and at your table. Gifts that go to do work and ministry, the work and ministry of Port Elgin United Church, of the Greater United Church of Canada, and out into the world at large. Amen. You may be seated. Together we join in these words of grace. God of mercy and justice, be with us. We lift our hearts to you, not because we have to, not because we are supposed to, but because it is how we respond to your unconditional love, because you have shown us your love through your calls to action. As long as there have been people to tell them, our ancestors in faith have shared stories of your mercy, of how you gave to the poor, clothed the naked, and sheltered the lost. And as long as there have been people to tell them, our ancestors in faith have shared stories of your mercy, of how you gave freedom to the enslaved, opportunity to the outcast, and peace to the war-torn. You acted with both mercy and justice, rescuing the Hebrew people from slavery in Egypt, providing them with manna when they were hungry. And your people acted with both mercy and justice, like the prophets who cried out to care for the widow, the orphan, and foreigner, and those who provided food, shelter, and community. You have shared your mercy and justice with us, not only as gifts to be received from you, but as gifts that we are to share with the world. We engage these gifts most clearly in your presence, in the presence of the Redeemer of us all, Jesus Christ. Together we sing. Jesus showed us what a life of mercy and justice looks like. In mercy, he gave food to the hungry. In justice, he broke social custom and shared tables with the powerful and the lowly at once. In mercy, he cared for the sick. In justice, he broke religious custom and healed on the Sabbath. In mercy, he had compassion for the poor. In justice, he spoke out against the empire that held them in poverty. In mercy, he washed his disciples' feet. In justice, he died without protest to expose a corrupt system. On the night in which he was betrayed to the unjust system that murdered him, Jesus protested by sharing a meal with his friends and disciples. There, he took the bread and broke it. He gave thanks for God's mercy in providing it and shared God's mercy by giving it to his friends, then called on them to remember the injustice of his broken body every time they ate this bread. After they ate, he took the cup. And poured it out. Gave thanks for God's mercy in providing it. Share God's mercy by giving it to his friends. Then called them to remember the injustice of his spilt blood every time they drank it. But that wasn't all. God's mercy and justice burst forth when Jesus died, and his resurrection gave hope to all those who hunger for mercy and thirst for justice. God will always equip those who seek to share mercy and justice. Even death cannot stop God's incredible grace. And so we sing.
Sing, Christ has died and Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Sing, Christ is died and Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
So we ask God's Holy Spirit to be poured out on this meal, so that these gifts of mercy, bread, and juice, that we may remember Jesus' ministry of mercy and justice, that these gifts of mercy may become for us the body and blood of Christ, so that we may show mercy and do justice, not just for ourselves, but for the transformation of this world. And together we sing. The table is set. This is not the table of the United Church of Canada, nor is it the table of Port Elgin United Church. This is the table of God, and no matter what denomination, no matter what journey you are on in this life, you are welcome at God's table. You are welcome into God's ever-giving mercy and justice. Come, join us at the table of liberation.
Thank you.
bread of life. Bread of life. As we prepare for our prayers after communion, is there anyone anybody would like me to name out loud? Sorry, I'm looking for a pen. There it is. Yeah. Is there anyone like me to name out loud? Yeah.
Amber,
sure. Yeah? Jacqueline. Walton, sure.
Rosie and baby William.
Anyone? Pardon? Okay. Anyone else? Well, as always, in these times of prayer, there is a moment of silence in which you are invited to say your own prayers, either in your heart or out loud. Let's pray. God, through this meal, we pray that your grace would empower us to do your justice, to offer your mercy, and do so with humility. God, we pray this day for all those who are in hospital, those who are sick, those who are dying, those who are in most need of tender and loving care. Be present, O God, with them, with their health care providers, with their chaplains. Be present in the moments of fear and doubt. Be present, O God, as they navigate this time. And God, we pray for those who are in moments of celebration, especially on a day like this, as families are gathering, as community is felt, birthdays, anniversaries are celebrated. God, we give thanks for your Spirit as it dances amongst us. Be there in those moments of laughter and joy. And God, we pray for the leaders of our world. May the decisions they make be right and just. May they understand what has been placed in their hands, not for power above, but power within. Power to help bring the marginalized up and out. Power to help eliminate the stigma that goes through this world. Power to care. And God, we pray for your creation, of which we are a part. A creation that sees the effects of climate change so obvious. May we be better stewards, O God, for it within this relationship with creation of which it is embedded in us. May we be more present to that relationship. And God, we pray for those that we hold closest to our hearts, those whose lives weigh on us this day. God, we especially pray this day for Rosie and baby William, the Waltons, Jacqueline, Amber, Jeffrey, and the family and friends of Marge Switzenberg. As we pray for Marge's soul and her dedication to you and your service, O God. And God, we pray for all those we name before you now in our hearts or out loud. God, we are grateful every time we come into community that we can recognize our place in the community and in the world. And so we pray for ourselves. May we be kinder to ourselves. May we be more generous with ourselves. And may we teach ourselves the love that you teach us. For you have given your Son as an example, your Spirit as an advocate, and now you give us the courage to do your work in creation. Amen. And so we pray together the prayer taught to us by Jesus of Nazareth, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Before we head into our closing hymn, I just wanted to share that there is a special birthday amongst us this past week, and it was Jenny's. And so I wanted us to try for Jenny's sake. Jenny doesn't have to play for herself, because that would be weird. Let's sing it without her having to do that for us. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Jenny. Happy birthday to you. And now we join together in our closing hymn, Your Love is Amazing, from More Voices, number 26.
Your love. Shines through. I can feel this God song
Christ has risen.
He has risen indeed.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
As we go forth into this world, we go with a daring and a tender love. We go to seek justice and pursue creativity. We go in peace, for the world is waiting. And whatever we do in this life, let us do it for justice. Let us do it for peace. Let us do it for love. And always in the spirit of the one who sends us forth, Jesus, who is our Christ. Amen.
Go. Watching.